1945, California's Sonoma State home. Charlie Follett, a 14-year-old ward, is singing in a field when he's ordered inside.
Darcy shot me with some kind of medicine. Supposed to deaden the nerve. Then the next thing I heard was snip, snip. And that was it.
Did they tell you what they were doing to you?
No.
They didn't have to tell him. He knew. A sterilization by force.
How did you know what it was?
Well, because, see, there's been others in there that had it before me.
The other boys at the home had warned him how much it would hurt.
Well, when they done this side here, it seemed like they were pulling the whole insides out.
The 1930s through the 1950s were the heyday of the eugenics movement in the United States. The goal, to rid the country of the feeble-minded, defectives. And it wasn't some fringe or secretive program. It was well known and paid for by the states where it was practiced. Entire families labeled shiftless, degenerates. 60,000 men and women, boys and girls, sterilized. Some living at home, others like Follett in state institutions. His parents were alcoholics and couldn't care for him and his sister. 32 states had eugenics programs, but California was in a league of its own. The Golden State sterilized 20,000 people, more than twice as many as the next state, Virginia, and a full third of the nation's total. It was led by California's elite, including, at the time, the president of Stanford University and the publisher of the Los Angeles Times. The efficiency of California's program didn't go unnoticed. In the 1930s, the Nazi Party in Germany was so impressed it asked for advice, and Californians leading the program were only too happy to help.
So eugenicists in California sent this book to the Nazis.
Yes, they did.
So the Nazis used this book as a model for their sterilization program.
Absolutely. Germany used California's program as its chief example that this was a working, successful policy.
California, the leader in forced sterilizations, but decades later, not a leader in making amends to victims. A few hundred survivors are still alive by one scholar's estimate, but the state has offered no reparations. Follett's tried for years, but says he can't even get a politician to talk to him, not even his own state representative, who also refused an interview request from CNN. His friend, Rudy Banlison, a nursing student, shows me letters he's written to no avail on Follett's behalf.
Do you think the state of California just wants to forget about this, forget it ever happened?
Honestly, I think they're just waiting. I mean, to sound so cynical, I think they're just waiting for the victims to die and forget this whole thing ever happened.
Compare that chilly response to the state of North Carolina.
The state of North Carolina is a partner with you and trying to bring awareness.
Governor Bev Perdue has invited sterilization victims to the Capitol, heard their stories, apologized personally, set up a task force to help them, and recommended that each victim receive $50,000 in reparations. In California, just a statement of apology by Governor Gray Davis in 2003, saying it was a sad and regrettable chapter in the state's history, and it is one that must never be repeated again.
An apology from the governor, is that enough?
No, no. It's a start, but it's only a start. These people deserve to be compensated, just like any other victim that has had their rights violated.
Where does all this leave Follett? He's 82, recovering from lung cancer, and hoping justice will come before he dies.
You know, Elizabeth, your reporting on this has been incredible because I really had no idea this was so widespread. 60,000 Americans forcibly sterilized. Do you know how many of those people are still alive?
You know, it's not known because except in North Carolina, Anderson, people aren't really reaching out and trying to keep track of how many victims there are. So, for example, as we said in California, one scholar thinks there's a few hundred who are still alive, but no one really knows for sure.
Aside from that statement by the former Governor Gray Davis in California, have any other officials there acknowledged what happened?
You know, Anderson, we have spent the past few weeks calling and emailing politicians in California, and the silence has been astonishing.